Okay, so this is a distant view of my house. You really can't see the whole thing. But what's interesting here is this mountainside I got. And there's all sorts of resources on the surface. And over here somewhere, you even have something more unusual. There you go. Emerald ore. And if we are willing to jump down here, I believe it's underneath the snow block here, two more. More potash ore if we need it. Some other resources again. And we're ready for that. Some more cave system. Granite, if we need it. Of course, need the water here. We need it. And for future use. This is on the edge. See where I planted a bunch of spruce trees in hopes they would grow. Obviously they're outside my range, so they didn't all grow, but some of them grew. So if I need more spruce wood, I can come over here. Mossy stone. Of course, a witchwood tree if I need another one. I already have some. I was touching up over here and I took out half of my trees. Yeah. Oh, and then here's my farm, which I harvested once already. I don't think what's special about the slightly larger chest, it actually will open up underneath the block like that. That's pretty useful. So, back in a minute. Okay, so I've redesigned some of the house. You see that I used chisel glass. This is Japanese bubble glass, and the narrow section I put this other type of Japanese fancy glass, and I did that all the way around. You'll see that I moved all my chests to the side, tinkered smeltery. So basically what I did was I looked at the space I had available, and I decided I was going to make a walkway like that. You can see the smeltery brick that I produced from the cobblestone that can go on the bottom, so one doesn't have to keep searching for clay, sand, and gravel to expand it. And so I have all these seared glass, some of it with lava. I was noticing that, well, what if you couldn't find enough lava to get started? Well, if you can find a town, you've got $2 of lava, which is enough to get you build a pickaxe. If you can't get that, I would go with a stone pickaxe through Tinker's Construct, the usual way through these, and then just keep ranking it up until you get digging fast enough to find the resources you need. Eventually you should be able to find lava, because obviously we haven't been to the Nether yet. I've also used the glass plate covers to cover this so I wouldn't accidentally step in. That's how I accidentally got blood in the other smelter at the other place. So, now the whole question is, where do we go from here? Well, one of the things we're going to need is bronze. Let's go ahead. We got aluminum brass ingots. We're going to want to make some bronze. So, we're going to be looking at tin and that. So, let's go ahead and get started. Whoops. Not supposed to be in there. Let's make lots of bronze. We'll figure it out later. Store stuff over here. So, blank pattern. Ooh, we need more than just that. We got some sticks over here somewhere. I did find a village or two and capture a few extra items, so I got some things that you wouldn't normally have. I'm trying to avoid taking advantage of those. And I, of course, lost all my sticks. Oh, they're there. Okay, so, and we're gonna need our cobblestone, which is over here, I believe. Probably should label this. Okay, so what do we got? These are the patterns we got. I want to move up in multiple ways. So first off, let's get, let's go ahead over here. Probably two's gonna be enough. Okay, so however many that was, it's not. Okay, things we don't have. I think that's a tough tool rod. It's a big one. We're gonna want binding one way or another. definitely going to want a hammerhead pattern. And we definitely want this large plate pattern. It gives us 5 to go. And so we already have an axe. So, I don't know. What else do we want? Oh, let's go ahead and get a big blade eventually. I forget which ones we'll need. So I think we got the first row, second row. That might be useful, I believe. Let's just go ahead and start making some pieces for making a sword. I forget which ones we need, but it's good enough for now. And that one too, all right. Okay. Let's stick all these in here. Oh, that's nice. We can actually sort it to some degree. I'll fill in the others later. So, I'm going to go ahead and make sure we have all the pieces we need. So, there's a good chance we're going to need that immediately here. So, I want to make a big hammer that will allow us to do some efficient mining and rank it up and move a lot faster. So, it's probably more than I can afford right now. Let's see. So we have to get some aluminum brass in here. So we got a whole bunch of bronze in here right now. So let's go ahead and move the aluminum brass to the bottom and pick this up. And which two items do we really want made out of that? So let's try this one first. And, well, obviously, hammerhead's the most important. We can upgrade the other parts later. Though, aluminum brass. So, let's go ahead. Now, see, there we got it. We got bronze, lots of bronze to work with. So, we're going to move in that direction first. We'll take care of everything else later. First, let's take a look at what we do know. We know that we have a lot of tin. I don't know if we can use tin. There's a lot of copper. So one of those two. Let's go ahead and pick up a iron axe at one point or another. So let's see, we want this guy right here. Put him in the tool station. Okay, I think it's letter O. I'm gonna bring this up quickly. Tinkers. So I'm going looking for the fancy stuff. So we got iron. I believe that's gold. Yeah, it's gold. The other one was iron. Of course you got your diamond, emerald, some really expensive stuff. And then we get into copper. I think copper's we're going to need a lot of copper. Copper, bronze. So we can use tin. So I'm thinking we're going to go with tin. Since I don't know a lot of things I'm going to use tin for. So what's that recipe again? We're going to need some seared bricks. Oh dear. Do we have enough seared bricks laying around? That would be convenient. I'm going to take a wild shot here. I'm going to dig down and steal some for blow. I believe it was like, let's see what happens if I do this. Yeah, put tin in here. Okay, so it doesn't like that. I'm going to just go ahead and swap. I'll be back in a minute. Okay, I'm back. Go ahead and take these out of here, and hopefully this particular tin will work. So go across here. We now have a tool forge. That's a key thing for us. So put the tool forge down. Go into the tool forge. Now we notice we have a hammer. We're going to need two of these. One of these, and I believe we're gonna make these out of bronze. I guess I should check before I commit. Oh, and we need that. So let's go ahead over here, I guess here, and I think it's that tough tool rod since. Just in case, who knows what we're gonna make it out of. I'll be back in a minute after I make a list of the different types of handles we should make, etc. Okay, I think I got all the pieces organized. So what I decided is we're going to do bronze. Of cleaned out the excess materials. And so what we're going to do is let's go ahead and get the hammerhead first. That's the biggest thing. And so that uses a lot of ingots. So, and then we're going to need two of these big plates. Let's see. Hopefully we don't run out. Now, so bronze is basically a trade-off between, that's a decent multiplier since we don't have slime yet. Oops, I guess I need to do another one of those. So, slime has a handle multiplier 1.5. Iron, bronze, aluminite, steel have multipliers 1.3. Bronze is easiest for us to get right now. There's some nether ores that we could use to get a higher handle multiplier. We can work with those later. Of course, we need a handle. So, in terms of dirt speed, of the materials we have easy access to, bronze is in the 700 range. Everything faster is either has real low durability, such as brass and silver. Brass can be made from zinc and copper, but has a durability of 15. Silver has a durability of 25. Electrum is like the best. Speed of 2000, durability of 100, but we'd never be able to rank up the tools. We'd have to keep on repairing them. So we're not going to do that right now. We're going to experiment with just bronze, and then we'll make a couple alloys and try a couple combinations as we go along. So I need an axe head. So how many of these do I have left? Ooh, more than enough. So I need minimum of 3 bronze tool rods to work with. So I want to upgrade all the tools. Problem with 3 is now we probably have an unusual number. So let's go ahead and just put one more in. So I'm just going to briefly sort everything away. Okay, we're back. So one of the things we need to do is let's go ahead and see how much bronze we have, because we should make some decent armor. Bronze is a nominal armor to start with. It's better than iron. And it's probably the best thing we can make right now with the resource we have, because we don't really want to use up. Well, the iron's not going to be better. The other ones really don't produce anything. The copper and tin gives us the bronze. Osmium, I'm not sure what we can make with that, but we need to save that. And nothing else, really. We don't even know if we've gotten down to the silver level yet. So, okay. So let's just go ahead and see how much we have. Let's go ahead and make the primary pieces. Oops. Yeah, that didn't work so well. So I need a bit more bronze. So let's go ahead and find some copper. 3 copper to 1 tin. It's probably gonna need more than that. We're also gonna have to add enough bronze to do repairs. So let's start with this for that. Okay, so let's go ahead and start making things. No, not here. Here. So let's look at our shovel. So our shovel has luck and reinforce 2. Here we get the skill points. Fortune 2 we're up to. So if we go over here, we can see the luck is gradually increasing as we use it. It's reinforced 1. Doesn't do us much good in terms of the redstone mining level because we don't mine with that. But let's go ahead and see what happens to durability when we add. That's weird. I thought we could just do that. Hey. Oh, I know, my mistake. You gotta repair it first. Common error. So first, let's get it repaired. Now, let's upgrade it. So we're gonna go from 550 to 714. No other changes, but now we have a little bit more durable shovel. Now, the pickaxe we have no problem with because it's, has moss 2 on it, which is repair. We have a speed got on there. We have a luck. That will, I think that precludes us from getting silk touch on this particular one. So we can actually have three modifiers. We can do all sorts of things with this. But for now, let's just go ahead and replace what I originally was. There. So let's see, that gets us from 550 to 714. I forget how we made the, oops, I did that wrong. So we gotta do it right. And check. And I can't see the durability, so there. Redstone is a pretty decent level. Just gotta push it up a couple levels and we'll be able to mine obsidian, probably. So that's pretty much the best we have right now. So let's go ahead and the big thing we want, which we'll probably be using anyways, is a big hammer. Bronze being the best we can do really right now. And of course you'll see that this mining speed is awful. And that we want a Tinker's Construct. Or do we go with this? This would be better. So let's go ahead and get a shovel head that we should be using anyways. Though actually it's only good for dirt, so. And there's 16 ingots in there right now. Now we can do one of these. So instead of an axe, let's go ahead and give this this matlock, I believe it's called. Matlock. Mat-talk. Let's go ahead and give that a try. Decent mining speeds. But we'll test it out, but I think it's awful on, so let's go ahead and stick this away. We'll just leave the bronze in there since we need it. Okay, so what do we have here? We need to go ahead and empty out our bronze before we mix it with something else, because there actually is some alloys. Gold and bronze make an alloy. A little higher speed than bronze, a little lower durability. We'll play with that later. But we really don't have gold yet anyways. So what do we have? We have six left. I'll take care of that later. Actually, let's just go ahead. Let's make one more. Let's see if we can just dump this in here. Take care of that. Let's go ahead. Now let's go ahead and we need shoes, and we need a helmet. I think we have just enough for a helmet. Of course, we want more bronze so we can repair stuff. Now it is PvP in the resource world, so somebody could be annoying if they wanted to be. So I made a little mine down here, rather than having more tunnels underneath my place right away. Okay, so I've already been down here quite a bit. Basically been taking out the resources I find them. Stuff I need, some certain materials. Oops, yeah, I forgot about that. So which way do you go? So, pretty much everything of interest has been removed from visible areas. Oh, I have some dirt I can practice on. So let's go ahead and get that matlock working. You see, it goes pretty fast. So, I removed all that. Let's go ahead and take a look at the, I'm a little bit further, still clumsy, but it's fast. It would be very nice to use the bronze shovel, but this is a multi-use tool. So let's go ahead and we're gonna switch to the bronze hammer, mining level iron. So let's see if we run into any difficulty using it. First off, let's go ahead and take out some coal here and all this here. I guess it's a bad idea. Not supposed to do that. Now we have a problem, we have oil. We don't really want the oil. Just gonna make our life bad. We're gonna use a pickaxe. You can see the speed of the pickaxe. Okay, so go ahead. Let's try. And we have. We don't want the oil to hide all the stuff we have. So go ahead and actually use a pickaxe for some of the fine detail. That doesn't look good, so let's go ahead and do that. So, what are we at? I think this is silver. Silver, I think that's gold. So we're not ready to mine gold yet. Okay, so what was I really looking to show you here now? So let's go ahead. Not many people know this, or not everyone knows this. So go ahead and take the cobblestone, turn it into a stone tool rod just by stacking two. Drop the coal on top of it, just mine. Now we don't have to go looking for wood in order to make torches. The other thing is, let's go ahead and move that over there. Now we do a right click and boom, we have a torch. Oh, nope. So let's go ahead and grab some of this. Let me grab the rest of this and then I'll come back later and I'll show you the main thing I wanted to show you. Okay, so here's the result of using the hammer for a while down here. You see I have quite a ways to go before I get another level. But advantage is I just left the ores exposed that it can't break. It means none of them will disappear if there's a server cleanup. One of the things I like about this particular mod pack is a high density of resources. So lots of different resources, different mod packs, all overlapping. It's great because you can get a lot of things. So I'm going to clean this up, grab as much as I can, don't leave the cobblestone behind, and then we'll move on to... Okay, we're down to roughly Y level 13. Been mining some tunnels back and forth, and finally we found diamonds. And I am going to use the... Well, I guess officially you're supposed to dig all the way around. Let's go ahead and see what happens. And nice convenient way to dig all the way around the diamonds is pick that's not fully ranked up. Okay, we'll have some redstone to work with, and now we're starting to find lots of diamonds. Okay, so the one thing I forgot to mention is we have luck on this pick. So basically about luck 2, I think, is what it's rated. So this one cache of diamonds, actually double cache of diamonds, is going to net us a whole lot of diamonds. So just those two piles. Look, here's a third cache of diamonds. We do want to rank up this pick because it is a luck pick, so therefore it's worth ranking up. So, there. Just this area alone, how many diamonds we got? We have 41 diamonds just from one cache of diamonds, so we won't have to do anything for a while.